Welcome to the information session on the Master of Science in Nuclear Medicine Technology. I am Crystal Glasgow. I am the clinical coordinator for the program, and I am going to talk to you about what nuclear medicine is, the program prerequisites, the application process, and much more. Let me start with, what is nuclear medicine? Nuclear medicine is a specialty of radiology. The difference between nuclear medicine and other imaging modalities, such as ultrasound, traditional X-ray, computed tomography, and magnetic resonance imaging, is that all the other imaging techniques look at anatomy or simulated physiology. Nuclear medicine creates images of physiologic processes and physiology in the body. Therefore, it is unique in what information it can provide to physicians who are trying to determine what is happening in the body. For instance, nuclear medicine can look at kidneys and determine left versus right kidney function, and determine something called an effective renal plasma flow, or ERPF. This information is important to determine how well the kidneys are functioning. The imaging is done over 30 minutes, beginning after the injection of a radiopharmaceutical. The radiopharmaceutical is designed to travel to the kidneys in the body, be uptaken, processed, and eliminated in urine, and then end up in the bladder. This entire process can be visualized using nuclear medicine imaging. Physical blockages can be seen on the image if someone has a kidney stone, and the left versus right kidney function can then be quantified. Nuclear medicine became a medical specialty after World War II, about 70 years ago. Approximately 15 to 18 million nuclear medicine procedures are performed annually for a variety of conditions in patients of all ages. There are over 100 different nuclear medicine procedures for every organ system in the body. So, what is a radiopharmaceutical? A radiopharmaceutical is a drug that is organ-specific and is tagged to a radioactive element. The radioactive element gives off gamma rays that our cameras can detect and convert into an image. One point to understand is that our cameras are really very large radiation detectors that are very sensitive. They do not emit anything and only pick up what is coming from the patient. Most radiopharmaceuticals are administered by giving an injection in the vein of the arm. Other examples of ways to get these agents into the body include inhalation for a lung scan and ingestion of a radioactive egg sandwich in the case of a gastric emptying study. The amount of radiation used is small and considered to be at a safe level. Any risk associated with the radiation used is far outweighed by the benefit of the information the physician will get from the exam. Nuclear medicine also includes some radiation therapy, but we are not radiation therapists, which is a discipline in itself. If a radiation therapy treatment involves a liquid or a semi-liquid source, such as nanoparticles, then it falls under the nuclear medicine umbrella because we know how to deal with and use liquid radiation sources. This part of our profession is expanding due to the new combined diagnostic and therapy agents called theranostics. What is a scintillation gamma camera? It is a radiation detector used to image the location of the radiopharmaceutical in the body. The radiation, in the form of gamma rays, is detected by the camera as it is emitted from the patient and formed into a picture with the aid of a computer. As seen here, the gamma camera can be in various configurations and is rather large. The camera pictured here is two-headed and allows for anterior and posterior views to be obtained at the same time. In addition, this camera can rotate around the patient to produce a 3D image of the organs of interest, which can be basically any organ in the body, such as the brain, lung, bone, kidneys, liver, heart, and more. As previously mentioned, the nuclear medicine test documents organ function and structure. It can identify a problem very early in the course of a disease, allowing earlier treatment. It may show that surgery is indicated or that surgery is not necessary. For nuclear medicine testing, the benefits far outweigh the small amount of risk associated with receiving radioactivity. The image here is a bone scan, And the areas that are hotter or brighter show more concentration of our radiopharmaceutical in that part of the bone tissue, indicating possible cancer, trauma, or infection of the bone. A few examples of what nuclear medicine can look at and possibly treat are diagnosing coronary artery disease, measuring kidney function, identifying the spread of cancer or evaluate a cancer therapy, identifying a stress fracture, diagnosing a blood clot in the lung, treating an overactive thyroid gland, killing cancer cells with radioactive antibodies, and much more. Here is an example of a nuclear cardiology exam. The heart is displayed in three views taken from a 3D image. This is an example of a normal image. We are looking at blood perfusion of the heart muscle, and this study is done in two parts. One part is done at rest, and the other while the heart is being stressed. The stress portion is done either by having the patient walk on a treadmill, which gradually increases in both speed and height, or if the patient is unable to walk, the stress is simulated by giving a drug that will simulate exercise and stress on the heart. As you can see, the images look like donuts and horseshoes. The parts or sets of images are compared to see if there is a difference between the set of images, or, as we like to tell our students, if there are bites out of the donuts or missing pieces of the horseshoes. Bites or missing portions could indicate heart disease, and specifically that blood flow is not reaching the heart muscle, either under stress conditions or under both stress and rest. This information would be important in determining if a patient needs to have a cardiac catheterization. The cardiac catheterization usually requires a hospital stay. However, our study may indicate that this is not necessary and was regularly used as a screening tool to determine if cardiac catheterization is necessary for that patient. Here, we see a kidney scan. As you can see, the kidneys gradually uptake the radiopharmaceutical, process it, and then the radiopharmaceutical follows the urine into the bladder, which is what is showing up on the bottom of the frame in the later images. These are sequential images over a 24-minute time frame that are compiled into 3-minute frames each. We can then go back and draw regions of interest around the left and the right kidneys and produce a graph of how long each kidney took to process our radiopharmaceutical. This study can provide a lot of useful information for a number of renal or kidney conditions. We can even do this scan on healthy individuals who are donating their kidney for a renal transplant patient. The kidney that is functioning best will remain with the donor, and the other kidney will be harvested for the transplant. This is another unique type of study that is part of nuclear medicine. Using a radioactive form of glucose and a positron emission tomography or PET agent, we can see a large lung mass that is cancerous in this image, which gets smaller after therapy. Other imaging techniques would only be able to see the mass and not be able to tell if it is active or uptaking anything, which would indicate a cancerous mass. Our technology can see this as part of the study and provide useful evaluation of whether or not a treatment is working to help cure cancer. What does a nuclear medicine technologist do? We prepare the patient, administer the radioactive drug, maintain and operate the gamma camera, as well as other equipment, collect and prepare images and other patient data, and use a computer to process clinical data. Why nuclear medicine technology? You will have direct patient contact and interaction. There are clinical rotations where you will be working side by side with technologists and gain practical experience. There is always something new in our field, new radiopharmaceuticals, new camera equipment, new software programs, and more. You will gain interprofessional skills and utilize cutting-edge science and technology. There are many job opportunities across the U.S. with excellent salaries. To enter our program, you can have any baccalaureate degree with the following prerequisites: pre-calculus trigonometry, introductory chemistry 1 and 2, pathophysiology, human anatomy and physiology, statistics, college physics 1 and 2, medical terminology, healthcare systems, and first aid and basic life support CPR. Our program is a Master of Science degree. It is 4 semesters, or about 15 months. It includes didactic courses in the classroom, online, or in the laboratory, and clinical practice in general nuclear medicine, nuclear cardiology, positron emission tomography, or PET, radiopharmacy, and much more. Elective specialty tracks in computed tomography, or CT, and magnetic resonance imaging, or MRI, are available for students. The benefits of taking these specialty tracks include the possibility of dual or even triple certification. For the application process, you must be accepted by the UAB Graduate School and have had a clinical observation. A formal interview with the admissions committee will be done before acceptance into the program. There is a February 15th deadline each year for first consideration. After February 15th, acceptance is based on availability of seats. The graduate school deadline is July 1st of each year. Nuclear medicine technologists work in clinical settings like hospitals, outpatient imaging centers, and physician offices. Nuclear medicine technologists may also work in administration, research, teaching, and as a commercial representative. Jobs are available all across the United States. Salaries are increasing, and starting salaries range from $45,000 to $55,000. There are many opportunities for advancement. If you need general admissions information, contact Carrie Glasscock, Director of Admissions for the Clinical and Diagnostic Sciences Department. For individual advising or transcript review, you may contact Norman E. Bolus, Nuclear Medicine Technology Program Director. If you want to schedule a clinical observation, you can contact me, Crystal Glasgow, Nuclear Medicine Technology Clinical Coordinator. I hope that this information session was helpful to you. We look forward to meeting you and hope to see you in our program.